Welcome back to MooMooMath. Today we're going to look at the intersections of circles and lines, and we are covering this for our second lesson and this last unit in our summer geometry course. Okay, over here on the left we have a picture, it's very visual, of a circle and line. How many intersection points do they have? They have zero, they don't touch at all. So a circle and a line may not ever touch. But a circle can touch and a line can touch in one place. We actually call that a point of tangency. You guys have learned that when you did your circle units. And then a circle and a line can have two points of intersection when we have a secant go through there, right? So we have three choices. Either they don't touch, they touch once, or they touch twice. So we're going to look at what does it look like to graph these and how many points of intersection are there. So you need to know how to graph a circle, which we just learned in the last unit, or in the last lesson, and then you need to know how to graph an equation of a line, which you probably started learning in about seventh grade. So here we go, let's try to do this. Okay, for a circle, we need to know the center, and since nothing is added to x and y, it's 0, 0 is our center, and our radius is the square root of 4, or just 2. So we're going to plot our center and then count up, to the right, down, and to the left, and we're going to draw in our circle. Okay, so there's our circle. Now let's draw our line. To graph a line, we need to solve for y. So we get negative y equals negative 2x plus 5 divide by negative. So y equals positive 2x minus 5. So we go down here to 5 and we plot up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1. Up 2 over 1. And what do you see? How many points of intersection do they have? To me, it looks like none. Right? Up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1, up. None. This one has no points of intersection, and that may happen. Okay, so let's look at the next one. Now, this next one's missing some parentheses, so if your handout doesn't have parentheses, add them in. Okay, we have x minus 3. Squared plus y plus 2 squared equals 9. So let's see, our center is 3, negative 2. Remember to take the opposite signs that you see. And the radius is the square root of 9, which is 3. So let's plot 3, negative 2. And let's go up 3, right 3, down 3, left 3. And plot our circle. And it may not be perfect. If you've got a compass, you can actually draw it with this as the center if you want to try that. Okay, and then y equals 5. What kind of line is y equals 5? That's a horizontal line. And it crosses right down here at negative 5. So it's going to go across here. So how many points of intersection does the circle and the line have? It has 1. And it's at the point positive 3, negative 5. And that is the solution to this system.